Hello traders, welcome back to my channel. So today I want to talk about a tip I have when it comes to trading with micros. As you know, the CME in futures offers mini contracts, for example, on the S&P 500 and in the NASDAQ as well. And a few years ago, they introduced what's the micro contracts, which is basically 1/10 of the size of a mini contract. So for example, one ES contract, which will be one E mini, each tick is worth $12.50. Each point is worth $50. And then one MES, which will be the micro version of this, is basically 10 times less. So each tick is $1.25, and each tick is basically the minimum unit of movement that this market has. And then each point is going to be worth $5. So you can see how with the introduction of this instrument, it gave small traders a lot more opportunity to participate in these markets. And this is why also futures have started to become a really sought after product, because also they offer great order flow trading opportunities. Since it's a centralized market, all the volume goes through and is reported through the CME. So for me, it's one of the best instruments that you can trade. So this is a tip that I have, and I actually use myself on Sierra Chart. I'm not sure if other platforms have this, but I'm sure other professional platforms might have this option as well. But you can look at a mini chart like I have here, but you can trade micro contracts directly through the mini chart, as I'm going to show you in just a second on the settings. Okay, and you might be asking yourself, well, why don't I just look at the micro chart and trade micros? Well, you can obviously do that. And if you're only trading, let's say, like price action and volume profile, and you don't need any delta or footprint or anything like that, then I would just say definitely just look at the micro chart, because pretty much if you compared a micro and a mini chart on like the S&P or the NASDAQ, they're moved pretty much almost identical. But when it comes to my trading, I place a lot of importance on order flow when it comes things, for example, here, like the footprint chart, or also if I have like the delta, for example, right here, that I use the session deltas that I have here, delta volume profile, or if I use as well, which let me bring it up here, I have it hidden right now, but if I have the cumulative volume delta at the bottom as well. This is a 5-minute chart, by the way, that you're looking at. We just open up on the week, so this is the extended trading hours. So as you can see, it has very little volume, and so far is just very tight range and low volatility. This is the session from Friday afternoon, regular market hours. But basically, when I'm looking at delta or footprint or things that are more to do with volume data for order flow trading, I want to be looking at the mini contract, because this is the contract that is traded most by professionals. And so this is the contract that has the biggest sizes coming in. So for me, it's very important to track the volume data on the minis when I'm doing my trading decisions. So the way, some people might just have mini charts open, the ES, and then they have another window separately with the micro, and that's where they execute the trades from. But the easiest solution for me is, why not trade micros directly on top of the mini charts? Okay, the way you do this is you go up to the chart settings button, you click on the chart that you want, and you go to chart settings, or you can just right click on it and choose chart settings here. And on the menu that you're gonna get, if you go to the first option here that says symbol, you're gonna notice this part right here. The first three selections is what we're gonna be looking at. You see one that says symbol action. This is set to the ESC23. So this is the December contract on the E-mini. This is the current contract. Then where it says trade and current quote symbol action, you can see that this is blank. And then below that it says use as trade only symbol, it says no. So what we're gonna do is down here where it says trade and current quote symbol, click on that, click select. This is gonna bring up another window. And I'm gonna go down here, futures CME. I'm gonna expand this and I'm gonna go down to MES, expand this now, and I'm gonna select, in this case, when I'm making this video, the December 2023 is the active contract now. So I'm gonna mark it, click OK. And now you can see that we have trade and current quote symbol as MES C23. And now where it says use as trade only symbol, I'm gonna click yes, okay? So this is how you want your settings to be. Again, this is on the S&P market. If you're trading NASDAQ, then this will be NQC23. And then underneath trade and current quote symbol, you would have MNQC23 for December. Trade only symbol, yes. Then you go and click apply all. Okay, and now you can see the chart is reloading. And now, if you look up here, you'll notice that it says ESC23 futures / MESC23 futures. Okay, so that means you're looking at an ES chart, but you're trading in micros. You can see I'm on simulation mode because I don't want to accidentally put in any trades on my actual live account while I record this video. One thing you're going to notice is you have to do this one chart at a time. So right here, let's say I have a 60-minute chart, 5-minute footprint, and 5-minute time. So right here, these charts are still set to the old way. So if I go now, for example, and I set, let's say I want to sell when we come into this swing low, if I put a sell limit here, let's say I want my stop here, and let's say I want to take this down over into this move down here, okay? You can see that I have my order set right here at 43.23, but it's not showing anything on my other charts. That is because I have not set the micro trading symbol on these other ones. So let's just keep that order there. And now I'm gonna go make the changes on this charts, and you're gonna see how the orders are going to come up here. You wanna make sure on every chart, click on them, go to trade menu, and make sure that the chart trade mode on is checked and active. And so I'm going to do the same. Right click, chart settings, and I'm going to look right here for the futures CME, MES, December. Okay, apply. Now it's going to reload. And now you can see, now we're showing the trade that we have here pending. And now we have ES as my main symbol, MES as my trade symbol. And then I'm going to do the same on the footprint. I'm going to bring the menu. I'm going to select as my trade and current quote symbol the MES. December. Okay. Apply. The chart is going to reload. And now you can see it's showing the trade again, and now I have ESC23 / MESC23, okay? And you're gonna have to do this for every chart on your chart book that you want to do this on. One thing that I do like to use on my charts, and this is just a little bit off topic, but is a little tip as well. If you go on each chart as well, when you go to chart settings and you do these things too, I also like to go into the linking tab. And since I look at all my charts just on the S&P 500, Then I put link number. I like to just select one, and then I put on the under symbol, I put yes and apply all. By having these settings on all the charts, that means all the charts are going to be linked to number one. And well, this doesn't show because it's far here, but all the charts are going to have an L1 just like this here. And that's going to indicate that they're all linked. And whenever I change the symbol on one of them, all the charts are going to synchronize and they're going to change to that symbol as well. Okay, so that's pretty much it. You know, and again, you might be wondering, what is the utility of this? Well, like I said, you know, the micros allow you to be trading with a smaller size, and that way you're able to, I'm going to cancel this order, and you see it disappeared on all my charts. So with the micros, you know, it's just going to let you have more flexibility when it comes to trading. Also, you know, if you're starting out or you're just trying to learn, definitely micros is the way to go, because you don't want to risk a lot of money. And even if you're trading like funded accounts like Apex or Top Step, Earn to Trade, all those, you know, a micro strategy is not a bad thing either, because the micros are going to allow you to layer in orders. For example, let's say I want this, I'm expecting this market to come up and fill this gap here, and I'm looking for a trade to get short once we get up there. You know, if you're trading minis, you're probably going to set a limit order to sell like right around here, but the market can come up and it can squeeze you like, you know, pretty deep into your order. And even if this market then would later just go down, you might get stopped on this trade. But since you're trading a mini, you know, you can have a really wide stop loss, because every point is $50. Even if you're trading like real money too, like, you know, you get offside several points on the minis and you're going to be down hundreds of dollars really quick. So with the micros, it lets you like layer your order. So let's say you can put sell here, 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 here. So with the micros, you can layer orders. That way, if this comes in here, it can, you know, squeeze you a little bit further. But then your average entry, you can get a better average entry than if you just set a single order to get short with one mini, for example. Whereas you can use, you know, 10 micros equals one mini. So, you know, you can work zones where, you know, instead of like here, just having one order here on the mini, you can just set a bunch of orders on the micro here. You know, you can take a Fibonacci retracement just as an example, and just set it there. And then, you know, you can say, okay, I'm going to put one at 50, one between 50 and 6180, one at 6180, one between 6180, 75, one at 75, etc. You know, so the micros let you work in zones instead of having to focus on having pinpoint precise entries like in the minis. Okay, so that's just a video explaining how you can set up your platform in order to trade micros through a mini chart. And again, this works on the e-mini S&P. This works on NASDAQ, micro bitcoins, any CME chart that offers minis and micros. You can do this on Sierra chart. I would definitely recommend, you know, first start testing it out on sim mode, or just do like one micro at a time, and then verify with your broker statement, or if you're on a funded account, verify in RTrader Pro, since all those work with Rhythmic. Just verify that the trade went through as a micro, so you don't start going crazy putting a bunch of contracts thinking they're micros and then you're putting in mini. So that's pretty much it. Just a little tip on how you can use this function on Sierra chart in order to take advantage of trading micros using minis order flows. Okay, that's pretty much it. Thank you for tuning in. Hope you have a great rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next video.